shooting. Good morning again, brothers and sisters. I do apologize for that break in the internet service. I trust we'll be able to continue uninterrupted. We continue at this point with our first scripture reading from the book of Job.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Job, chapter 29. Reading verses 1 to 20. Job 29, 1 through 20. Job again took up his discourse and said, "Oh, that I were as in the months of old, as in the days when God watched over me, when his lamp shone over my head, and by his light I walked through darkness. When I was in my prime, when the friendship of God was upon my tent, when the Almighty was still with me, when my children were around me, when my steps were washed with milk, and the rock poured out for me streams of oil. When I went out to the gate of the city, when I took my seat in the square, the young men saw me and withdrew, and the aged rose up and stood. The nobles refrained from talking and laid their hands on their mouths. The voices of princes were hushed, and their tongues stuck to the roof of their mouths. When the ear heard, it commended me, and when the eye saw, it approved, because I delivered the poor who cried, and the orphan who had no helper. The blessing of the wretched came upon me, and I caused the widow's heart to sing for joy. I put on righteousness, and it clothed me. My justice was like a robe and a turban. I was eyes to the blind and feet to the lame. I was a father to the needy, and I championed the cause of the stranger. I broke the fangs of the unrighteous and made them drop their prey from their teeth. Then I thought, I shall die in my nest, and I shall multiply my days like the phoenix. My roots spread out to the waters, with the dew all night on my branches. My glory was fresh with me, and my bow ever new in my hand. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And so we turn now to page 55, 55. We recite the canticle, Prayer of Manasseh, or a Song of Penitence, page 55. O Lord and ruler of the hosts of heaven, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and of all their righteous offspring, you made the heavens and the earth with all their vast array. All things quake with fear at your presence. They tremble because of your power. But your merciful promise is beyond all measure. It surpasses all that our minds can fathom. O Lord, you are full of compassion, long-suffering, and abounding in mercy. You hold back your hand. You do not punish as we deserve. In your great goodness, Lord, you have promised forgiveness to sinners, that they may repent of their sin and be saved. And now, O Lord, I bend the knee of my heart and make my appeal, sure of your gracious goodness. I have sinned, O Lord, I have sinned, and I know my wickedness only too well. Therefore, I make this prayer to you. Forgive me, Lord, forgive me. Do not let me perish in my sin, nor condemn me to the depths of the earth. For you, O Lord, are the God of those who repent, and in me you will show forth your goodness. Unworthy as I am, you will save me, in accordance with your great mercy. And I will praise you without ceasing all the days of my life, for all the powers of heaven sing your praises, and yours is the glory to ages of ages. Amen. We now have our second reading from the book of John.
reading from the Word of God, written in the book of John, chapter 10, verse 31 to 42. The Jews took up stones again to stone him. Jesus replied, "I have shown you many good works from the Father. For which of these are you going to stone me?" The Jews answered, "It is not for a good work that we are going to stone you, but for blasphemy, because you, though only a human being, are making yourself God." Jesus answered, "Is it not written in your law, 'I said you are gods'? If those to whom the word of God came were called gods, and the scripture cannot be annulled, can you say that the one whom the Father has sanctified and sent into the world is blaspheming because I said, 'I am God's son'? If I am not doing the works of my Father, then do not believe me. But if I do them, even though you do not believe me, believe the works, so that you may know and understand that the Father is in me and I am in the Father." Then they tried to arrest him again, but he escaped from their hands. He went away again across the Jordan to the place where John had been baptizing earlier, and he remained there. Many came to him, and they were saying, "John performed no sign, but everything that John said about this man was true." And many believed in him there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. On page 40, the Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Page 42, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us,
that we may know the joy of your salvation.
Grant peace within and among all nations,
and teach our leaders wisdom.
Endow your church with faithfulness,
and her servants with knowledge and true godliness.
Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed,
that your justice may be known among all people.
Lord, renew your spirit within us,
that in us and through us your will may be done.
Our collect is on page 178, page 178. We pray together, collect proper 18. Grant us, O Lord, to trust in you with all our hearts. For, as you always confound the proud who confide in their own strength, so you never forsake those who make their boast of your mercy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We turn back to page 45, page 45, and we pray the third and fourth prayers, the third and fourth prayers. Into your hands, Lord, we commend ourselves this day. Let your presence be with us to its close. Strengthen us to remember that in whatever good work we do, we are serving you. Give us a diligent and watchful spirit, that we may seek in everything to know your will, and knowing it, may gladly perform it to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the rest of the past night and for the gift of a new day, with its opportunities of pleasing you.
Grant that we may so
pass its hours in the perfect freedom of your service, that at evening we may again give you thanks, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we'll sing our first hymn, My Jesus, I Love Thee, I Know Thou Art Mine, number 531. 531. Mm-hmm. Amen. Surely, if we have not been loving Jesus before, no better time than now to start loving Jesus. We continue in a brief moment of prayer, and this morning we are giving Almighty God thanks for His graciousness, His unconditional love, His endless love. We're giving God thanks for His mercy in our lives, for the opportunity for us to hear and respond to His word. We are thankful for the fellowship that we call church. We are thankful for God sending Jesus into the world to bring salvation to our hearts. We are thankful for opportunities again and again and again to draw closer to our God. And so with all that we are grateful for, all that we give thanks for, family, friends, food, shelter, clothing, we pray indeed that we would allow all of these blessings to strengthen our faith, and that we grow in our desire to share our blessings with others and to help others to see and to experience the light of Christ in their own lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray this morning for all who are bereaved, all who grieve. We pray for those who struggle with the death of their loved ones, family, or close friends, those who ache and yearn. We pray for God's blessings, God's peace, God's strength and comfort in their lives. We pray especially for those who are not able to be with their loved ones, to share with them in these final days, their final moments. We pray that the assurance of God's presence with us and with them will indeed be comforting to us. We pray for them to have, we pray for those who are on their deathbeds to have a holy death. We pray that they would know they are not alone, that we lift them up even now in prayer, and we pray Almighty God to receive them into His holy arms. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
This morning, now we want to remember our children, the youth of our nations, and especially this week, as many in different islands are returning to school or have returned to school. We pray for their safety. We pray for the teachings they have received at home, at school, in church, in Sunday school, and in other organizations and from other places. Teachings especially about obedience and discipline. We pray for our children that even now they would recognize the value of obedience and discipline, the need to follow protocols, the need to follow the instructions given out to them as they return to school. We know that they are returning to a different environment. They're returning to a place that they are familiar with, but a place that now has different instructions and rules and guidance. We pray that our children would allow obedience and discipline to govern their minds and their actions, that they would leave our homes safely, and that they would return safely to our homes. We give God thanks for all of our teachers, administrators in education, and all others, cleaners, and all who are involved in our schools and our educational system, all who are doing their very best to keep our children safe while still providing them with a sound education. We pray, and we pray that as we send out our children, that they would continue to make very good use of the opportunity to be educated. And with the education, we pray that they would allow obedience and discipline to form a substantial part of their training and of their education. So we give God thanks, and we pray for the continued safety within all of our schools around our nation and our various countries throughout this region, and indeed throughout the world. Pray for the safety of all our teachers, and pray for patience, pray for understanding, and we pray that all will be well. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us remember to pray also for those children who struggle, who come from difficult homes, in addition to having to fight against a pandemic. We pray for our children coming from distraught homes, broken homes, homes where they are very uncomfortable, very afraid, homes where they may not have food, proper breakfast to leave home with. We pray for our children who are being abused and who are quietly suffering. We pray for those children who, for some reason, although they have parents who care, they do not feel loved. We pray for all of the various things that affect our children. And we pray that as Almighty God, as he raises them up another day, that they may rise up with some sense of worth and value, and that they would allow themselves to be carried on the wings of God's love. They would believe that there is somebody out there who cares. We pray for Almighty God to turn them in our direction, that we may be able to offer a helping, a word that helps, that uplifts, that encourages them to be the best that they can be. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And finally, let us pray for those children and in those countries where children are denied an education, where children are forced into child labor, into becoming child soldiers, where children are kidnapped, taken away from their homes, forced into prostitution, into slavery, where children and or women are trafficked, human trafficking takes place. We pray indeed for the safety of our children in every way and in every form. And we pray indeed that all of us will become active voices who speak out and who stand firm for the betterment of our children. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
This morning, our prayers are asked for, for Ralston and Horace. We lift them up and we pray for them. We pray for their home lives, family lives, and we pray for the strengthening of their faith. We pray for the assurance, for their assurance that they are remembered, that they are loved, they are not forgotten. We also ask, remember, to pray for Father Vitet as he recovers from surgery. Pray God's blessings upon him. We give God thanks for his healthcare professionals and pray that they would continue the good work that they have begun with him. We pray for any others who have asked for prayers at this time. And let me just have a brief look. Okay, we don't have much by way of prayer requests. But let us remember also those who celebrate this week, a birthday, an anniversary, or some wonderful occasion. We give God thanks. And this morning I thank Almighty God for the period of rest and refreshment, for bringing me and my family back safely, and that we can resume our time of fellowship, of worship, and service to Almighty God and to our fellow men, to humanity. We pray that we who call ourselves Christians may have a true desire to grow in our faith, to learn. And as we learn, we pray too that we would also have the desire to share, to teach, and to encourage. We pray that we would better understand ourselves as human beings and as Christians. We would better understand ourselves in terms of our purpose, our Christian calling. God has called us into worship, into communion with Him, but He has also called us into specific ministries. He has called us to perform a specific work and a role for Him. Let us pray for that discerning spirit in our lives, that as we better understand what role, what ministry God wants us to perform, that we would do so with glad hearts, with willing hearts. We pray for our desire to burn, to burn, to burn, to burn, that we become zealous for God, for the things of God, for the work of God. And so, as we reflected on Sunday, we pray again for that virtue of courage to grow within us, that whatever our calling may be, we would do so courageously, we would perform it courageously, not concerned or worried about what others may think or say, but knowing that we desire only to please our God. And so we pray, dear God, that the virtue of courage would swell within all of us, that we step out in faith and not in fear. We step out boldly, not as cowards. We step out with the understanding that we are loved, we are called, we have a purpose. So we pray with thanksgiving in our hearts, we pray with the joy of the Lord in our hearts. We pray that as we go forth this day, others will be blessed because of the life that we live. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We also ask to pray for Lorraine Brown. We pray for her and the wider family, and we pray that Almighty God would continue to surround her, would continue to uplift her, and we pray that whatever challenges she may face at this time, we pray that the hand of God would indeed deliver her as God sees best. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Now we turn to our prayer books and we offer our prayer of dedication, page 47, the prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now our hymn, 522, 522. I am thine, O Lord, I have heard thy voice, and it told thy love to me. 522.
I am thine, O Lord,
Amen. I am thine, O Lord. We are thine, O Lord. So our prayer this day is that we will be drawn nearer. Our prayer is that we will become more courageous and that we will live our faith to the honor and glory of God and not in the fear of other people talking. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. And just before we dismiss, let me just apologize for that earlier break we had in our feed. The internet went down, but I'm happy we were able to persist and resume. I'm happy that you joined back as well. Wonderful to see the familiar names and faces, and I trust that you had a fairly good summer as well. We return tomorrow evening, Wednesday evening, evening prayer at 6:30 evening prayer. Trust and hope we'll be able to see you and share together. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace, and at the appointed time, may they rise in glory. Amen. A blessed day to all of you. Take care. Bye-bye.